Now we have the glass effect inside the Figma, and I decided to make this video to show you how you can use this effect and in general share my opinion about this effect. So bear with me until the end of this video if you are interested into this topic. My name is Kia and here is the Kimo. Welcome to my channel. Apple released their new design language a while ago. One of the most important parts of that new design language was, of course, the liquid glass effect that they introduced to the design world. We all know that the reactions from the design community side toward this trend was so different, and in general, it is a very controversial topic. Many people really liked it, and many people were against it because they had some concern about the misuse of this effect, which might violate many design parameters. However, this is not the topic of this video. I'm not going to talk about what is good about this effect and what is not. Maybe at the end of the video, I say a couple of words and share my opinion about it in general. But the main thing that I would like to show you in this video is, of course, the new effect that Figma team released in their latest update, which make it possible for us to regenerate or make the same liquid glass effect within the Figma using the native solution, which is very cool. I have to admit that I'm very happy about the quick reactions that the Figma team is in general doing toward the trends, toward the things that the designer might need in their design tool. But before we get into the main part of this video, I have a news that I'm very excited to share with you. I've decided actually to show a couple of work and designs that you are sharing with me at the beginning of each videos from next videos. So if you are also willing to show your works to everybody else in my videos, get sure to get in touch with me via one of the channels that I'm going to mention. You can join to our Discord server. You can share your work with everybody else in that servers. And of course, I'm going to pick up a couple of them and share in my videos with the other designers. The other way that you can reach out to me is, of course, via Instagram. You can DM me there, or you can use email and send me email. It's really up to you. If you want to see your work and designs in the next video, get sure to send it to me. So now let's jump into the Figma and see how we can use this effect, where we can find it, and in general, how we can apply this effect on our design. Actually, it's very simple. The first thing that I can mention at the moment is that in the beta version that we can use at the moment, we can just apply this effect on frame. So in order to be able to see the effect, we need to have one frame. And then here from the effect section, you can click on this basically plus button here, add a new effect. And from the effect type, you can open this drop-down menu and choose the glass as the effect type. So let me bring this menu on top. You can see actually it's on the beta version, so there might be some bugs, some performance reduction, some problems here and there. But overall, everything works well, so it's ready to be used. So to be able to see the impact of this effect, of course, we need some background element behind this frame to kind of see how the light is behaving, or the basically reflection of the light is behaving when we hover this element over other background element. So to show you this, I will write down one text. Let me increase the font size. Plus, I will make one parent frame maybe. It's not necessary, but let's do that. And then I'm going to get sure that this frame number one, which we have the glass effect, let me maybe rename it to glass effect. Get sure that this is on top of the other elements, other design element basically. And maybe let's make the background a little bit white. Immediately you can see that when we put this text behind this frame that we have effect on it, we have basically some transparent effect, some glassy effect. However, we could make this before as well using the transparency and blur effect, which I'm very fan of it actually, even right now I'm going to explain it later why is that. However, this effect is slightly different. But before we go further, let me also add one maybe image using the all stock plugin. I will import one image here. I'm going to again get sure that this image that we have here is behind the glass effect layer that we have. So now we have this text, we have this image, and then we have this glass effect. You already can see the refraction, the light refraction here, some effect. But to be able to see this effect more, I'm going to open the glass effect window. And here you can see that we have a couple of parameters from the top, which will help us to customize this effect. Starting from the light direction, like how the light is basically, what is the light angle over this element, which you can see the impact on the edges of this. Let me maybe go back a little bit and open the effect one more time. It's a bit hard to see at the moment. The reason is that when we select one element, we have this blue indicator, and you might, okay, now you can see when we change it, the blue indicator is gone. So you can see that the edge, the light that is reflecting from the edge of the element, the angle is changing. And plus we can also change the amount of light here, which has this impact that we can see less light reflecting from the glass. Let's increase it a little bit. And the angle doesn't matter at the moment. But you can play around with these things to build your custom glass effect. The next one is the refraction, which I guess is very simple. It shows the way that the light is changing its path when it's going through a transparent element. This will increase the impact. So basically, the light is going to change its way more. Then we have the depth, which is showing the depth of the glass. When you increase it, and then you have the refraction on a high amount, you can see that the light is breaking more, and you have some sort of nice effect that you can see at the moment, which is very cool. And then we have this dispersion, which is basically showing how the different light with the different length wave, they are behaving and refracting when they are going through the element. So you can see this kind of cool effect that the red and blue lights are getting separate from the main light. You can see the change when I'm changing it, you can see the impact. And the last parameter is, of course, the frost, which I guess is very simple, is adding some blurriness to the background. So here we have the pure glass, and then we can have some frost to have a little bit blurriness. Let me very quickly add some corner radius to this element. Now you can see that we have some sort of kind of magnifier feeling, however it's not magnifying, but it's basically just a glass and refraction of light. The next point is that you don't have to stop here. You can also add other stylings in other, let's say, effect to your object, to your frame, to build more custom look and feel. For example, you can come here in the fill section and add one background color. You can increase the transparency, reduce the transparency, and build this glass effect with different colors. But you can also add a gradient. This gradient also might help to kind of build some cool effect that can make the design even look better and more interesting, let's say. That's one thing. Plus you can go further here. You can add a stroke to your element, which is normal. You can increase, reduce the stroke the way that you used to do on the other frame. And at the end, you can add other effects. So you can come here, click on the plus, and for example, add a shadow, which you can see here. Now the object is dropping some shadows behind it. This glass effect is working like the other effects, and you have also access to the other stuff to build more custom look and feel. For example, here I add the texture. Everything is actually possible, and that's a very cool thing. And as we said, this is a frame, and we can apply this effect on the frame. Therefore, we have access to all properties that we have for a normal frame. So nothing is going to change. For example, here I add one text layer within this frame, and then I'm going to select it and go from layout section here and apply auto layout on it. Ta-da! So basically, we have access to the auto layout properties and we can make anything that we used to make. For example, here I add two text layer. I can change the or adjust the basically layout direction. I can make a grid even. So everything is possible as it used to be before. So that's a cool thing. Actually, it's the first time that I'm using this new feature, and I'm recording it to share with you. Therefore, maybe a couple of stuff I'm not so sure about it. For example, the next point for me is to see if this effect is working properly prototyping tool, so we can kind of animate it or not. If we can, it would be very cool, but I'm not sure also about the other effects so much, because I did not do much prototyping using this kind of effect. But let's give it a try, huh? I'm gonna make one frame here. I'm going to make very, very small and easy prototype. I'm gonna duplicate it. And here I'm going to reduce the size of this frame to something a little bit, maybe a smaller, something like this. So I'm going to select the frame number 2. I'm going to prototype in panel, and I'm going to make a new interaction. I don't need the, let's keep the trigger of this interaction on click. And for the action itself, I'm going to navigate. Of course, we have only one frame. So now if we click on that frame, it's going to navigate to frame number 2, or no, the frame number 3, actually. And the animation type, I'm going to keep it under smart animation to be able to see if we will have a smooth animation for this or not. I'm going to do the same thing for frame number 3 to be able to get back to the default variant. So navigate to frame 2 and smart. Now let's click on frame number 2, and here we can click on this to play our prototype, or we can open this drop down menu and click on preview to see the preview within this window. So okay, now we have this effect within the preview, and if I click, you can see that we have this smooth animation, which is very cool. I'm very happy to see this. And now I wonder if I can have this effect in the Figma site or not. But yeah, I will give it a try later and see if it works. But for now, this is very cool that we can actually use this effect in our prototype and have this smooth animation using the smart animations. This effect is very cool. It looks very nice, and it will really boost the design, most probably. Of course, we have this concern about the contrast. If we use this element as background of the other elements, or even if we use it as a foreground element, still the contrast is a question if it's visible enough for the users or not, especially when it comes to the accessibility criteria. But regardless to this point, it's cool to use it in our design. However, I wonder if we can transfer this effect in the way that we are building it to the developers, that they can pick it up and kind of generate this effect in their environment as well. If we are designing something for iOS, this might be not really tricky. However, based on the properties and parameters that we had in the effect window, I assume we need to kind of inform the developers also about this parameters. For example, when I decide to have the refraction parameters 100% or whatever it is, then the developer need to also be able to see this. So let's switch to the dev mode and see what the developers will see. So when I select this glass effect, first of all, I see that because I applied the auto layout, the developers, if they decide to see the CSS, basically properties and stylings, they see the auto layout properties, but nothing about the effect that we added. And the last thing that I want to show you is that if you would like to see what Apple does in their new design system with their new design language, you can come to the assets section here. And here in this basically preset or the libraries that are available for use for everybody, you can see this iOS and iPad OS 2006 or 26. You can click on plus and add this library to your design file and open the file. Actually, here in the material, we have the liquid glass here that we can use it everywhere in our design. Let's maybe add it to this frame. Okay, here you can see how the effect is working. We have a little bit of frost. I didn't know that the apple also has frost. Maybe it was like this, like really transparent when they released this effect, but now maybe they also add a little bit of frost. Anyway, the thing is that you have access to the original stylings of this element from the library. Therefore, you can reuse it in the way that, as I mentioned, Apple does. So that was it, actually. I tried to show you a couple of stuff that you can do with this effect, how to use it, where you can find the properties. It's very cool, actually, to have the possibility to create the glass effect with this level of realism, like having the properties for deciding how the refraction of the light should be, how the light should behave for, and based on the different parameters, and physically working well. Plus, I saw that we can have this apply the smart animation in our prototype and have a smooth animation, and the effect is working pretty well. This is cool, but there are two points I want to mention, which might be the downside of this new thing. It's a trend, of course. It's changing the design world, not only the appearance of it, but of course the feeling that it brings to the design. This dynamic movement, this kind of let's say macro animations and interaction that comes with this the new design language as well. All together, it's going to actually change, or I don't want to say change. It's not a really big difference, but it's gonna at least bring some new stuff into the design world. That's not a question. However, using this kind of a style is very tricky in the design, especially when it comes to the accessibility in our design, which is a very important parameter in our design. So if you want to use these things, you need to get sure that you are not violating any other design parameters. That's the first thing. The second thing was that I tried to use this effect on other system that I have, on my actually Mac, and I felt a little bit, I don't know, the performance wasn't good enough. I could see that there are some lags, the performance kind of reduced dramatically, I have to say. Sometime even I had some lag that I had to refresh the browser. So in general, the performance is a question while we are designing and while the users are going to use it. And the last point, which I'm not so sure about it, is that how we can transfer our design to the dev team, and how they can actually recreate what we are designing. This is a little bit not so clear at the moment for me, but let's don't forget that this is the beta version, and definitely this they're gonna work on this new feature more and more to get sure that everything is working well. If you have watched this video until now, before you leave the video, I would like to remind you one more time, if you want to see your works, your design in the next video, get sure to get in touch with me via one of the channels that I mentioned before, the Discord server, via the DM in the Instagram, or via email. So you can send your work to me. I will check them and share a couple of them in the next video. Thanks for watching this video. See you in the next one.